Hello and welcome to Proceeding Onward in America.
POA.
Well, today we are going to discuss about KOA and work camping.
Yes, and also about Amazon and possibly a couple other things that happened while we were down in Florida.
All right. Now, we did get the job at the KOA in
Hollywood,
Florida. And it's a small campground, very, very tight from the videos that we showed you last time. Mm-hmm. We met a couple of great people there. It was only about four workers at first. For us, we basically got this so we can be closer to my grandmother. And it pretty much worked out perfectly. But this was pretty much a franchise KOA. So the deal was that we worked there for
37 hours combined.
37 hours combined. That's 18.
It was about
18 hours. About 18 hours each that they wanted us to work. And that was just going to cover up our campground of where we park in the RV at. Now, at the time, it was a great deal. We really didn't really matter. We just wanted to get as close as possible, have a place to park our home, and be able to visit my grandmother while she's in the hospital in Miami. And this was only about like 45 minutes away, so everything was perfect. He did explain to us that if we go over these hours, he would pay us per hour after that. And we questioned him about that, and he said he was going to give us the time. And then when we got there, he didn't want to give us the time. So we was kind of a little bit upset, but we were still trying to work out what we could work out. And being that we was only working, 3 days a week to squeeze in the 18 hours, that wasn't bad at all. And Jag was pretty much enjoying it as well, because we was able to leave him outside at first and just leave him on a long leash. And I just had to keep checking up on him to make sure he didn't go around the table three times and get himself stuck.
Yeah, our spot was secluded from everybody else, so we really didn't have to worry about people around our campsite.
Walking around.
We were at a dead-end street,
yes,
which people kept trying to drive down anyways, and drive down the walkway because they were too lazy to turn around and go down the right street. So we had a lot of people driving their cars down that walk path.
Yep.
And even when we put cones up, they'd get out of their cars, move the cones out of their way, drive down, and then exit the next street over. So we got real creative. We even put like
a tree
in the way. We put seashells. We put whatever we could. And people would still get out of the cars, move the cones, everything out of the way so they could just drive down the walking path instead of getting out of the car and driving down the appropriate street.
So it was kind of interesting, I should say.
You even had trucks go down. They go down pretty fast, too. Actually, we have that video.
The trucks would they will come, they'll stop, but being that they can't fit down the walkways, so you hear them beep, 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 doing all the backup just to turn around and get around. There was one long truck that had to really back it all the way out because he had a trailer attached to the back.
Yeah,
he couldn't do
point turn.
Nothing. But everything turned out to be okay, and now my grandmother has officially passed on December 3rd mm-hmm. of last year. And this is when we pretty much kind of at the same time had enough with the KOA that we was at, because it was time to go anyway. We tried to make it work by putting all these hours in just the 3 days so we can pay for our spot. But then we also needed some sort of an income as well to get gas money to be going back and forth.
And pay for food.
And being that he wasn't giving us the extra hours to pay us something, I decided to try to get a job at Amazon. That was just about like 10 miles away.
Yeah. It wasn't the work camping Amazon that everybody else does up in like Kentucky and so forth. This was just a normal Amazon building,
yes,
down in Opa-locka. And just working there during the holiday season.
And it was pretty good. They paid good money, $15 an hour. And they do want you to work like a horse, 10 hours a day and possibly 6 days a week. Mm-hmm. So it was kind of like difficult trying to manage that as well as put in my hours at the KOA, so I was able to do everything that I can. But then Amazon started asking for more hours, because first they only guaranteed me 4 days and 5 days as a maybe, but the 6 day was never guaranteed. But then out of nowhere, they started throwing 6 days on me, and I couldn't work there 6 days a week while I still had to work
3 days
at the campground for at least 2 to 3 days. So it was hard trying to juggle those two jobs. And then the manager at the KOA wanted to change up everything, and now he wants us to work 5 days, 3 days, 3 to 4 hours a day.
Yeah, he wouldn't allow us to work over 4 hours a day, because if we went to 5 hours, then he had to give us a lunch, and he didn't want to pay us for having a lunch break. So either we weren't getting paid.
So it really turned into like a struggle trying to work for there and work for there at the same time. But like I said, my grandmother ended up passing just around the same time, so everything was just easy to just let go, and I didn't really have to stay there anymore. So I just told Amazon I can't do it no more, and we told him we're gonna leave as well. And we ended up having our funeral service for her in Key Largo, and we had all of our family together. We ate out and we had our get together, and then we pretty much just packed up and left, I think, a couple of days after that.
Yep. During that time frame also, though, we were just sitting watching a football game, the Cowboys, and they actually ended up winning that day. This is during the time that we were having issues with Pat. So what we did is we opened up the KOA work camping work site, which you pay $35 for a year.
Yes.
And you can see what other KOAs are hiring. And you can also make a job application. And you just fill out all your information, and you can make it visible or private. Well, we ended up making it visible.
Because we was leaving.
We were leaving, and we're like, all right, if somebody else just contacts us,
we'll head in that direction. And we end up getting a contact from Lee in Dallas, in Texas.
Yep. Right after Dallas won the game. And he always wanted to go to Dallas. It's right after his grandma passed away. And when she reached out to us, we saw it as a sign.
We pretty much packed up, we left, and there's nothing bad about the Hollywood KOA. It's a small operation. It is franchise owned, so the owner, he owns it. He's just using the KOA name.
He also owns Davey as well.
He pretty much runs them at his own command. There is some KOA rules and law and regulations he got to follow, but then there's others he can make up on his own. Mm-hmm. So it was pretty much an interesting task working there and trying to make everything work. So it worked out when we needed it, and when we didn't need it, everything worked out on its own. So we're pretty much headed over to Dallas after this. So we decided to drive all the way up to Kentucky to see her mother for Christmas, and then we're going to work our way down to Dallas. So you're going to see all of those videos in the future as well.
And just remember, this is all stuff that happened last year. So where we are right now is not reflective to what the videos are coming out. So please do not get upset that we didn't stop by, say hi or anything. This is something that happened in the past. We're just trying to catch up of the season being so hard and difficult to post about.
Now the KOA and the corporate, which is where we're going in Dallas, we're going to pretty much talk about that a little bit later when we get our videos up to Dallas, and y'all learn more about how that KOA operates and functions.
But yeah, as this video shows, as we throw in little clips here and there, we did also meet some amazing people while we were at KOA in Hollywood.
Yes.
And we actually had a night where we sat by the fire, listened to Dave play some songs and his guitar, and just watched some football and all this other stuff.
I forgot about Dave came, another word when that came through. Yeah.
Yep.
Hey, Dave.
And Kayla.
Guitar playing was actually good, so I remember that.
Yeah. They're up in Washington State right now. Okay. So maybe we can see them as we head up to Alaska, hopefully next year.
Hopefully.
But one person that we definitely want to give a shout out to
is Kimberly.
Kimberly C. Paul. She is actually on a tour, doing a book tour, and we met her at the KOA in Hollywood. And while she was there, it actually, as most people say, you meet the people when you need to at the right time.
Yes.
So she worked for hospice for 17 years, and when we met her is right when Fabian's grandma died. And her walking through the grieving and stages of opening up about death, and during the times of when people are about to die, it kind of hit home a lot, but it was a great person to talk to during this time. I did purchase her book and all that, and got her signature, and all that hurrah, and I did read some of it, and it does have some great stories in here. It talks about people that she was for hospice for when she was by the bedside as they're waiting to pass in their last few days of life, and also the loved ones that she had to go through as well, and so forth. So it covers a lot of life lessons. One of the quotes that she has in here, I didn't want to mess it up, so I wrote it down, is design your own life in death around what matters most. So us as RVers, what we're doing is we are designing our life. We are going around becoming what we want to be and so forth. It can happen to anybody, but I feel as we're traveling, we are designing our life and what matters most to us. Yes. And some people, actually, they're like, why are you doing this? Or some of the future questions that we'll cover later on in another series, because we actually do have some questions about our work camping experiences. But anyways, so Kimberly and her dog Haven are traveling cross country, going, doing these different shows and promoting her book and so forth about hospice. And like I said, she's been doing it for 17 years, or she was doing hospice for 17 years, and now she's going around
doing her book tour.
Doing her book tour. She also has a podcast called Death by Design. So if you listen to podcasts, feel free to jump on there. And she does do some YouTubing and Instagramming. We'll put those down below.
We'll put all the links down below, including the link to, if you want to buy the book as well, we'll definitely have a link of where you can find the book and where you can order the book. She has a hard copy and she has an ebook, so you don't even have to. You can actually buy the ebook copy and just read it on your iPads or your phones, and you won't have to worry about extra weight in your camper if you're one of those people.
Yeah. So Kimberly, you're awesome, and hopefully we meet up again with you along the road.
Pretty much after we leave, we're gonna head over to Boondocker's Welcome.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna stay there.
Which we didn't record. Sorry.
But it was a great couple. They had a great yard, and they even had electric and sewage and water at their location.
And they were close near Airstream dealership.
Yes. So it was pretty awesome that we found a good place, and we're just going to continue our journey until we head all the way up to
Kentucky
and then Dallas.
Yep. After Kentucky, we head down to Dallas, and we'll show you some more stuff as we are proceeding onward in America.
All right. Oh, yeah. We did purchase some stickers and some magnets as well. I just remembered this. These are our magnets, and the stickers we just ran out of, so I'm thinking we're going to have to purchase some more. So we've been handing out some stickers, and some people are getting the magnets because we understand not everybody has a magnetic fridge. But if you want any, just leave a comment down below or leave us a message on Facebook or Instagram and let us know, and we'll see about emailing you a sticker.
Yep, and we'll leave a tip jar down below with a link where if you want it and you want to leave a donation of any sort, feel free to.
Until next time,
keep following us on
Facebook,
Instagram,
Twitter,
and become our Patreon.
Yes, where we can make more videos like this.
Yep, and also comment down below and subscribe and ring that bell.
Forget that thumb up.
Oh yeah, thumbs up.
Thumbs up. All right, until next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
So we are just finishing up our time at Hollywood KOA in Hollywood, Florida. And see some more of our adventures throughout
Florida.
Ready, Jaggy?